So, I'll tab out of this. Game capture. Diablo free. Bam. So, in theory, beautiful. Okay, so we got our monk. We're playing on hard, yes. Okay. But no, it's so much easier now. Everybody complains about how hard it is to, how do you know what machine you're gonna buy? Like, you don't know shit back in the day. I remember, having fucking crashes in games because we needed to, have a different version of DOS. Because the one that we had was, old or something, and that one was beyond anybody in our family, so we had to, call in my older brother for that shit, and it was just I don't miss any of that. It's so much better now. Okay, so where we got? We got bonus in Act 1, thank Jesus. I'm gonna go ahead and bump the sound up, because I'm pretty sure I have it very low. Yes. Because normally I listen to music while I'm playing Diablo 3, but... Exactly! People just don't know, man. That was the thing, is up until... I want to say, my teenage years, so, not late 90s, early 2000s, all of the computers that we had were basically hand-me-downs from my older brother, because he was always a tech head. And... it was just nuts! Oh, this is gonna end badly, I think. I remember... God, what was it? Not upgrading RAM. But, you'd go, to Electronics Boutique or whatever to buy... basically any computer component. These were back in the day when, wow, this character is not going to be long for this world. I've got a pack of these guys on me, a unique group over there. Alright, we're not gonna do this. We are going back to Tristram. We're gonna do some other things where I can actually survive. We'll just go outside of town here. But no, it was just crazy how different the climate was. Because that was when being a computer techie, you were a fucking nerd. Oh, you're kidding me. This game is legitimately just trying to straight up murder me now. It's oh, hey, guess what? Your first, boss of the game, spawn in, fight Skeleton King. I think I can probably kill him here. Careful. He doesn't spawn a small army. But yeah, it was very different. And that's another thing, is driver issues. Most people, all they know about now is my graphics card driver needs updated. Back in the day, we had to update fucking mouse drivers, we had to update sound card drivers. If it was a computer component, we pretty much had to update drivers for it. And it was just holy crap. Whereas nowadays, you plug your mouse into your computer and it just magically works. It used to be like that, kids. Alright, so we got some gloves that are far superior to the nothing that we had previously. And, we can dual wield on this character too, nice. Some holy damage, and this is attack speed. And we got Lashing Tail Kick is a deadly roundhouse. Alright, well, it's an AoE. I'm appreciative of that. Let's go ahead and run around. But it's different. I'm not complaining about it, though. Because, believe me, even the jump from, installing, say, Windows XP to Windows 7. Installing Windows 7, you tell it to install, and it just does its thing. With Windows XP, you've got to, babysit the thing, because it'll pester you for shit and all of that. And don't even get me started on installing something like Windows 95. You'd be sitting at that computer for, 3 hours, flipping out floppy disks and shit, waiting for it to finish installing. That was just bad. You talk about shit I don't miss. There you go. And then, it'd be done and you'd be oh, you formatted your hard drive wrong and you've got to do it again. or you don't have your driver discs anymore, and this being back before the internet, if you didn't have those driver discs, you were pretty much up Schitt's Creek.
My path becomes clearer.
And just, it's like, it's insane. Hand axe of slaughter. I just remember, folks, you can't spell laughter. You can't spell slaughter without laughter, and I just ruined that. I'm gonna pass on the shield, I think. I'm gonna go all out offense here. So we got a new skill. Deadly Reach. Project lines of pure force, huh? Let's see what it looks like. Oh, the animation, that's... Oh, I'm using this just because I think it looks cool. I love how, like, we go from a tangent on video game development-related stuff to talking about, like, old computer hardware. It's ridiculous. Don't even want to get me started on, you know, old-school D&D. There's rants to be had there, but probably not in the kind that most people will be supportive of, because I think old D&D had its place, but I think new D&D is... generally speaking, superior to it, depending on what you're going for, I guess. If you want more... Oh, man. That's another thing that I, like, I guess, blocked from my memory along with the, you know, AOL dial-up sound is the old PC speakers. The game that I remember most was actually Bard's Tale, I think. It was the first Bard's Tale. Had that, like, shitty little tune that played. Oh, man, PC speaker was the worst. Man, freaking... PC speaker, I'd just... Like, I'm not even gonna lie to you, Captain Plants. You could do it, and I would just mute the sound. I wouldn't even just... No, nobody deserves to go through that. Like, at least MIDIs you can, like, listen to. Like, they're discernible. PC speakers were just, like...
I don't have enough spirit.
Just, like, horrible. I can't even, like, make some facsimile of what it used to sound like. It was just bad. Dark times, man. So we got some pants. I'll take pants, we can get rid of these knuckles, don't need those. And we got a new skill, Blinding Flash. Blinds enemies for 3 seconds. Elite enemies recover faster but suffer a chance to miss with attacks. So it's completely useless and I'm not going to use it past, like, the very beginning of the game until I get a new ability. Great.
Help me. It's inside me. Inside!
Well, I mean, if you're into that. Insert that's what she said here, although I'm sure Captain Plant will probably hit that before the lag gets to him and he notices that I'm making fun of him for it. But, yes. I don't miss old computers. I miss old, like, game consoles, like Nintendo and stuff. That, I think, is an era that we are never going to see anything like it again. But old PC gaming? Not really something I miss too much. Oh man, AoEs. Gotta love those AoEs. None of it. Damn it. Try to get out of the way and get stuck on terrain. That is the way of things. So coming to Briss. In a belt. You gotta just throw that in a corner there. Apparently grabbed a bunch of blood shards. Huh. Okay, and 10,000 gold. I need to check something. I need to make sure this character's hardcore. Yes, okay. Just making sure. Interesting, because I didn't think I had picked up like 10,000 gold there, or any blood shards. Do your hardcore characters have shared money and blood shards? Because if so, I think that kind of defeats the purpose of hardcore a little bit. I don't know. Whatever. Alright, let's try something new. Farm to siege. I have noticed that they've added a lot more events to the game. Like, that there used to be back when I used to play back in the day! Let's see how this thing works. Wow, so imba. I think my roundhouse kick is a little bit more useful here. This is like the coolest attack. It's just freaking cool looking. See, I know you wanted me to go like knuckle user on this one, and I do intend to switch over it once I find a pair that isn't crap.
Not enough spirit.
Not enough spirit. Cut that shit out. I think it's the accent she's rocking out here. Although she is from, I don't know, the Diablo version of India, if I would have to guess. Which, like, that's a thing that Blizzard has done with basically all of their, like, fantastical IPs that drives me fucking nuts, is that they've got, like, the we've got to include everything in our games thing going on, where, you know, we've got a Japan-esque area, we've got an India-esque area, we've got everything, and it's just like, come on, guys, make an identity for your game and stick with it. Quit being, like, a freaking mush pot about everything. Freaking Pathfinder RPG's official campaign setting does that too. Ow. And they take it even further where they've got like sci-fi and stuff in there, and I just don't know where I stand on that. Go ahead and equip my wings. Don't think I have anything else. Nope. But that's just kind of me being crummy. Die Katana. I like Texan too. I like Texan too. I like Heretic. Those are just good games. Again, they don't make stuff like that anymore. Die Katana was just bad. John Romero did not, in fact, make anyone his bitch. He did something, but I don't think it was what he wanted to do. Like, I want to say, well, we're pretty tanky here, but I seem to recall similar feelings with my barbarian before I got froze to death. Really? Like, that just doesn't make sense. Like, it kind of defeats the purpose of a hardcore character when I've got access to basically infinite money. Well, I won't say infinite money, but theoretically, if I had a high-level hardcore character, I would have infinite money, and... I don't get where Blizzard's design is, like, 98% of the time. It seems like they just kind of, like, throw shit out there and pray people like it. And most of the time, everyone does. I don't know. I need to stop bitching about stuff. It's too late to be cantankerous about crap. Okay, what's that? Also junk. So we are looking for a dead beast out here.
Not enough spirit.
Yeah, you're not wrong. EA is the devil, etc., etc. Every so often, though, they do release something that isn't garbage, and I don't buy it because EA. Right, exactly. I mean, it's weird because I understand that, you know, these companies have to do the safe thing because that's how you make money. I get that, but it's like, fuck, guys, give it a break. Like, I get that the purpose of a company is to make money. I understand that. But the practices that these companies are doing nowadays, like, I would best describe them as predatory, some of the stuff they're doing. God, what was it? I was reading about something earlier. The new Batman game, Arkham Knight, I think. It has 8 different pre-order versions with different DLCs and stuff that come with them. And why? Why would you do that? If, like, it is just pure greed at that point. It is just pathetic. Because you know what's gonna happen, like, a year from its release, they're gonna release the Game of the Year edition that has everything, and... I couldn't tell you guys the last time I bought a game at full price, simply because if you wait, you get the better version. Like, you don't have to deal with bugs, you don't have to deal with shitty servers, and so on. It's just freaking terrible. Then people gobble it up,
my
of course.
My will falters.
Well, quit faltering your will, lady, and kick this thing in the head until it stops moving. There we go.
Those scavengers trapped my poor wife and me down there for hours. I'm sure she'd love to meet you and thank you for your help.
Really? Alright.
This is the woman who saved our farm.
This is...
Oh.
No need to be shy. We owe all of this to you.
I must be going.
Wow. Oh,
she's nodded off.
That's dark. Dang. Oof. Alright, well, we did find a couple pretty good weapons here. Can you dual wield spears? Oh, you can. That's totally ridiculous. And a much better belt. Sweet. That pleases me. Wow. Clear the Den of the Fallen. The Triune Reborn. Alright. The little Hitchcock. Yeah. Just a little Hitchcock touch. Crazy. Destroy Triune Monuments. Okay. I don't know. Like I said, I need to stop raining too much. And oh my god, there's that rainbow, and that's why this game is terrible and not as grimdark as all of the other games. Rabble, rabble. That is one thing that, like, of all of the complaints about this game I was never on board with, is that it's too bright. That's just dumb. I understand that the old Diablo games were dark, but come on, guys. You're digging. And you missed. Dump. Alright, so I assume this is one of the monuments. Oh. Dark Conjurer. So what happens? Oh, okay, so I can't just destroy it. I've got to kill these yet. Wow, those are some groups. Probably a bad idea to get myself all surrounded here, but I'm pretty confident in my ability to explode these dudes. So not particularly worried. Massacre. 25 monsters killed. 25 critter beasts dead.
You're a new Tristraman.
Don't care about your journal entries, game. I didn't care about them the first time through. I'm not gonna care about them this time through. Okay. We got one up here. Ooh. 25% magic and gold finance. Acceptable. Hey there, go folk. Oh man, I'm probably gonna be like aggroing two groups of these things, aren't I? Oh, this is gonna be a good fight. We got a rare in there. Lyrilla by Lyra the Terrible. Yeah. Oh, and of course we've got, like, freaking dick trees coming in after us. Nope. Alright, this thing's gonna knock back, which is not particularly worrisome. I'm gonna get rid of this stupid tree, though. Oh, I should probably change the little descriptor on the left to know that I'm playing Diablo 3. Kind of fond of Assassin Tooth Metal Age. Man, I gotta start streaming like during the day so that my non-Aussie bros can catch some of my streams. I'm sure that there are other viewers out there beyond my international audience. Popular though I may be amongst them. And this is just a freaking clusterfuck up here. Internet does appear to be holding out really well though, which is really good. Oh, there we go. Give me that level. Solitaire deathmatch. There was this game I used to play ages ago. God, I can't even remember what it was called, but it was basically... It wasn't solitaire, it was like a card-based strategy game, and you play it with just like a normal deck of cards. And it was very, very simple in that, like, say, an ace, B, everything that wasn't an ace, and king, B, queens, and under, and so on. But it was surprisingly fun because the people that developed it, it was like a PC game. The people that developed it, they had like these little graphical representation of armies for every card that you could play and stuff. And I don't even remember what that game's name was. I think the company that developed it was called like White Mask Software. And last time I looked into them, they weren't around anymore. I think it was called Empires? I don't remember. Can I change it to Solitaire? No, I wouldn't. The game being played, this little notification thing, it's actually on a set list. They don't have where you can just enter whatever you want, which is a shame because there are some games that I've played that I didn't have, or some games that I played that weren't on their list, I should say. And it's like, well, what do you put on there when they don't have the game you're playing type deal? Like, I think... Oh, what was it? Maybe Delver? When I did the really quick stream of that as a precursor to... I think it might have been Daggerfall. I don't know. But they didn't have that on there. I'm actually halfway tempted to start streaming like some Neverwinter Nights or something, play like some custom modules or something. But again, that's another game where there's some time commitment there. Did like Neverwinter Nights, like, of all of the games, do Neverwinter Nights? Well, like, oh, hey, hit points. I lean back to stretch for just a second, and the game's like, hey, guess what, it's death time. Neverwinter Nights is a very good game, and I like it a lot. It's just that, generally speaking, it's not what I would consider a fast-paced game. I actually really like Neverwinter Nights 2 more than Neverwinter Nights, simply because of the party controls in it. I think it had... where you could actually control your party members, like, that alone made Neverwinter Nights a superior game in my eyes, but, alright, it made Neverwinter Nights 2 a superior game, but Neverwinter Nights is never gonna be beat on the content, because you get stuff like the community expansion packs, and, oh god, what was it called? It wasn't CEP, because that's the community expansion pack. There was, like, this huge, like, mod that added, like, I shit you not, like, dozens of new classes and stuff to the game, and oh, so good, but I don't even know where that went off to. I'd almost be tempted to, like, I keep saying like, and it's driving me nuts, but I'm tempted to take something where... We'll play like some community modules, for example. I actually know there's an Eye of the Beholder community module that reviewed pretty well. But I had thought of maybe doing like, basically make my own module. I'm I would say fairly proficient with the game's editor. So, like, take the editor and make myself adventures based on community suggestions. Less divine energy heals you, huh? Huh. Alright, I'll take that. I'll take an extra heal. Basically, like, take adventures based off community suggestions. Like, the community could give me, you know, like, say, a paragraph, and I'd make an adventure off of it, and I'd run through it, but then I would also link that, you know, somewhere. And basically what I would do is make a super module based off of all of these community suggestions. So, like, say there's a town hub, for example, and that's where, you know, your home base is or whatever. And every community suggestion module would work off of that. It's kind of like how DDO does things, where, you know, you've got Stormreach as your town hub, and then there are just, like, you know, all of these adventures based off of it. And the thought of doing something like that is very tempting. The only downside to it is that, like, personally, I would want to play with a lot of mods, but it can be a huge bitch to get a lot of mods working properly together, so I don't know, you know, how that would work. But I don't know. Like I said, it was just kind of an idea. Don't know if there's necessarily going to be anything like that, but no, I would like to play Neverwinter Nights sometimes. Sometime. I think that would be pretty fun. I actually used to. There are some. One thing I actually wanted to do, like, ages ago, like 2 or 3 years ago, when I used to be really big on the multiplayer aspects of the game, there are community run worlds. They've got a term for them. It's like, I think PW's player worlds, where basically, you know, a person or group of people would develop, like, these super modules. It's a little weak here. It's okay on my end. God damn it. Fucking shitty puns. But I don't know. It's a nice.
Not enough spirit.
But one of the things that I had wanted to do was kind of not necessarily play through, but kind of review various player worlds. One in particular I was very active on. And play that. It's just something that one of these days I probably will make a video for it because I feel that it deserves it, because it's probably one of the best player worlds I've ever played on. And, you know, folks should know about it. I think it's called Anea. Weird spelling though, so Googling probably wouldn't get it for you. But it was really cool, really, really interesting world. It's the only player world I ever actually capped a character on. Although, admittedly, that was because capping characters on it was not particularly hard. Once you reached a point where you could reliably kill the holders really quickly because they were worth a crap load of experience points. Oh, hey. Murder these guys. Another heal. No, it's not bad. Probably not something I'm going to keep again once I hit a point where I have something a little bit more interesting. Which is probably going to be next level. But, eh, it's not bad. It's something that I could probably see having on, like, W or something once I hit, you know, 20 or whatever. It's something I could see having on my skill bar further in the game than just now. But yeah, I don't know. Neverwinter Nights is kind of tempting. Talking about it now has kind of got me itching to play it, which I naturally blame Captain Planets for. That's why I play a lot of games on my stream, because he pesters me about it on Twitter, and I'm like, that sounds like a good idea! That's why I played freaking Thief tonight, was because, like, you should play Thief or something. And, you know, my brain's like, dude, that's a good idea, you should play Thief. And then I'm like, okay, we're gonna play Thief. And I apparently missed some loot up here. Sucker throwing a spear at my butt. Get out of here. I don't know how Neverwinter Nights would stream, though. I remember at one point, ages ago, I was actually tempted to Let's Play it, and I ran into some issues. I can't remember what that was, but I think it was Fraps refused to capture the screen or something. Or just, it might have been that it ran really, really poorly for some reason. I don't recall. I just remember there was some issue that whatever it was immediately flipped me from, you know, this is something I would like to play to, this is something I'm probably going to have to wait on. I do have, one thing I do have for it though is Infinite Dungeons, which is a pretty cool little module, one of their premium modules from when they did that. I have kept my copy of it for ages. I don't think you can even get it anymore because of, I think it's Wizards of the Coast screwed them and won't let them disseminate them anymore. What do we get here? Oh, this is our dashing strike, alright. Oh, that's pretty cool. So how's this work? Oh, it builds up charges. Weird. Okay. Pretty cool, though. Got a radiant chest with, wow. That was kind of disappointing. See any upgrades? Oh, we got boots. And we didn't have boots before. And we got a rift fragment, and we got an iridescent tear. Shuffle our crafting ingredients off to the side. Stream coming in any better there, Captain Planets, or is it still conking out on ya? Carinia's lost wagon. So they can knock that barrel off.
Not enough spirit.
Now. Dang it. Okay, let us go to, I guess, Cathedral.
Lazarus.
And the only reason I take those is for the experience points.
The storm breaks.
Something breaks, I have no idea what. Kill this thing. I'm just rezzing everything. Eight enemies with knockback. High belt. That is better than nothing. Oh, we have a thing up here. No idea what that is.
I'll bring that down.
What's evil though? Oh, I have engaged a skeleton. I hate that it uses your, like, I keep saying like and it's driving me nuts. It is such a shitty filler word, and I was bitching about it on my Fall Let's Play earlier, too. But I hate that it shows your freaking, let me think here, let me use my words. It shows your BattleNet ID instead of, like, your character name. I don't get it. Well, this is better, so we're gonna go ahead and equip that there, and that there. Okay. Let's find out what these do when I break them. Yeah, I don't get Lockdanon. I also noted that they changed his name, because it didn't used to be, I think they pronounce it Lockdanon now, and it used to be Lockdanon in Diablo, and it's just Blizzard being Blizzard. I got nothing. They gotta give them accents because it's, I don't know, a quick way to build character if I had to guess. Teeth rocks, you dicks. Hey guys. I like this dash attacks. They're ridiculous. I love them. Is this Skullthorn? No, this is Sorrow the Slayer. possessor of creative names. We gotta kill that DM summoner in the background that keeps raising everything. There. We have here an enlightened trend. Ooh, XP boost. Yoink.
What you ask is impossible.
I just asked you to left click, lady. I think you can do that. Come on, Spring, you got this. There you go. Okay. And that is superior to the one we have. Alright. Oof. I like how quick the monk is. Whereas the barbarian was kind of like this pondering juggernaut of destruction. The monk just kind of like flies everywhere and murders absolutely everything. Oh, we have a new skill slot. Oh, wait. So I probably got some of these. Alright, so chance to... I see you coming in here. Come on. How does the skeleton laugh? Okay, we have some skills. Fleet foot, move speed, no. Damage you deal reduces enemy damage by 20%. Okay. So what do we have here? Thunderclap. Every punch that hits all enemies for 120% damage and causes knockback. Alright, I'm going to switch back to Fists of Thunder because Thunderclap gives it a nice AoE. Lashing Tail Kick. We have Vulture Claw Kick, where it releases a torrent of fire. Okay, and we have Tempest Rush. I'm going to go with the Vulture Claw Kick because I bet you this is going to look just bad. Okay, that's pretty cool. I did not mean to use that, and I'm kind of irritated that I did. I'm going to switch it out as soon as it is available again. I'm going to switch it out for that Tempest Rush thing. Oh yeah, you guys got nothing on my AoEs. Oh, glorious. Alright, switch this out for Tempest Rush. Let's see how this works. Oh, this is the doofy little spinny run thing. Alright, that I am not going to keep. Not a fan. Besides, then we're not fist fighting. We gotta be a fist fighter. We're kung fu fighting here. Fists and feet only, no spinny stabs. Oh, I'm coming for you guys. I think I'm not. Okay. Oh, I like the like flame spin attack. That is one thing I will give Blizzard, is that this game is, like, legit fun to play now. It was not when it released. Played Skeletal Fighters. Okay. Oh, played Skeletal Fighter, I can't read. Alright, there we go. That wasn't too bad. A Broad Axe of Wounding, which is better than our main hand. Wow, which is better than our offhand. Okay. And resort stuff here. I wish they'd let you sort it from, like, I wish they'd let you have it sort in this way, where it just went kind of top to bottom instead of left to right. I don't like that it sorts left to right. I don't know why. I just don't. Aw. None of that. Oh my god, the AoEs.
A vicious strike.
A prodigious blow. See, there's something I could play. Darkest Dungeon or something. I actually kickstarted that game, but I didn't kickstart it at the level that they would get you into the beta, because they said, oh, it'll be out by February, and it's May now, and it's still not out, and...
I will not accept this. It's not my time to die.
Oh, he's mad. Sorry, Spirit, but you just got Fuego kicked. I'm gonna go back to town. We got shit to sell.
I've dug out a right good bunch of things for you this fine day.
Okay. See, nothing there I care about. Those are better. Those. That's better. Look at I'm running around and I still don't have any, like, torso armor. I keep saying like and it's driving me nuts.
How do you feel about our undertaking?
Very dangerous.
Then why are you here?
With great danger comes great profit.
I love him. Easily my favorite character. I'm sure I could actually probably bring one of them along with me if I wanted to.
I
just don't want to.
Without equal, I've collected them from all parts of this world.
I might grab those because life per hit. And I guess I'm gonna buy these too. Whatever. Don't need any repairs. I think there's only two shops here. Let me see on that. Nope, there's a third shop. Alright. Way out here.
Hey, no one around here appreciates the work I put into acquiring these fine wares.
Yeah.
It's not easy, I can tell you that.
Nobody appreciates you digging up graves and doing other things you probably ought not be doing. Buy the necklace, and strength doesn't do anything for me. So, yeah. Talk about some, you know, compelling inventory system there, man. I gotta carefully manage what stats I'm rocking out here. Because, you know, if something has strength on it, it's completely worthless to me. That's one thing that chaps me about this game, is that basically, when you're a class, you need vitality in one stat. I just hate that. Say, for me, intelligence and dexterity are completely useless. Give them something. Really. Rage of the Damned. Horus the Night Stalker. Horus the Night Stalker, I don't think is going to be too long for this world. Oh shit, your supercomputer crashed? What happened, man? I thought this thing was supposed to be some legendary thing. That's what she said, by the way. You did not miss anything cool. I went back to town and I vendored a bunch of shit. Well, it depends. How long were you crashed? Did you see my whole Neverwinter Nights discussion about, like, basically having the fan base suggest module ideas for me, me designing them, running through them, and then releasing them out into the wild based off of a giant city hub area? Because that was a thing I talked about briefly. Flaming spin kicks! I'm so easy! Ah, the family box. Gotcha. Yeah, it was when I was gabbing about possibly playing. Yeah, my thought was basically, like, I would have, say, like a central town area, like a hub city or whatever, and then I would have people, like, say on Twitter or whatever, submit like a paragraph quest idea. You're not worth your enormous beast. I see how it is. I don't get the beast. I get the family pet. That sounds wrong. But nah, I'm not offended or anything. It's not a big deal. But yeah, so that was my idea. It was basically, you know, community, throw me a paragraph, I'll make a quest based on it, and attach it in some place to this hub city, and then I'll run through it, whether on stream or just on my own time in a recorded video. And from there, I would just basically keep, like, a link somewhere that would host this giant mega module, and every adventure that people suggested to me would be added to it. Generally, since they'd be, like, a paragraph, they wouldn't be, like, you know, 4-hour long ROMs. I'd probably design to be something you could run through in, like, half an hour or so. But, I don't know, it was just an idea. I totally needed to spinning fire kick that thing to death. Totally necessary. Man, we're catching up where Equinox was before he got croaked. I think he was sitting at 14 when he died, and we just dinged 11. an active skill, crippling wave. Tempest Rush Rune. Northern Breeze. There we go. Okay, so we're gonna pull back for a second here. Oh, wow. That is a hell of an upgrade. Alright, there we go. Have a look-see here. Let's see, what was that? I think that was on Deadly Reach? No, wait. Oh, it's a new skill. Each of a series of large sweeping attacks deal 150 weapon. Okay, so crappy damage. Let's have a look-see. Well, it certainly is an AoE. It looks cool. But it's weapon-based, and we punch shit until it stops moving. That's our bag, and we're sticking to it. Dead adventurer is dead. Okay. Oh my god. Rats in the walls. That is actually probably one of the most memorable of Lovecraft stories to me, was the rats in the walls. Fucking. Well, I would probably have guidelines. Like, I'm not just gonna be like, you know, because there are gonna have to be limitations just due to it being Neverwinter Nights, so there's like gonna be engine limitations and stuff. But, you know, I'd prefer it to be, you know, not necessarily serious all the time, but not necessarily completely silly. But, like, 'twas the night before Christmas, like, I don't know. I don't know. I don't even know how I would work into that and be like, it's a dwarven holiday coming up and their gift-giving spirits are angry and the local druids are trying to appease them by sacrificing small children or something, and you've got to go stop them. So there. So I guess in that case, you know, I could work with, you know, 'twas the night before Christmas. It's just a dwarven Christmas, and apparently their nature spirits get angry around Christmas time if you don't appease them for some reason. Details. Okay. What do we have here? Ooh. Couple goodies. A spirit song. Oh, so that's the monk item. Alright. Yeah, the Christmas spirit, there you go. It probably wouldn't be called Christmas because I'd want to keep it, like, relatively speaking, I would want to keep it thematic to D&D, so I would find some, just call it, like, Dwarven Krampus or something, I don't know. And just work off of that. Well, that wasn't too terrible, all things considered. So what is our last task? Kill Garak the Afflicted. Sure. But no, that could work. I can even see, like, having, you know, this monster in this place that, like, it has monsters that it calls them its presence to the world or something. Like, you kill them and they explode into other monsters. Those things, children. Well, mythologically, there are things like that. I mean, like, Krampus, for example, is actually, I think, I don't even know what mythology Krampus is from, but it's like a Christmas spirit that, you know, eats children in their beds and stuff. There's all kinds of just horrible shit out there like that if you look for it. You just gotta know where to look as I run through the fire. And I still don't have torso armor, and it's kind of driving me nuts. I'm gonna do my dash here just to speed things up. Oh, it looks like our target is at hand here. Come on, skeletons. God, the AoE on this character is just immense. I love it. Oh, we gotta kill 100 enemies here too. That's gonna be kind of a a pain in the ass, I think. Did I just steal something on now? An Iron Maiden that some of the enemies are like, I saw a health bar. Did I knock something into the Iron Maiden? Okay, well, this is... I'll open the bloody chest and kill Garakthius. Like, okay. Yep, I already took it. Too late, I'm leaving.
Not my time to die.
Yeah. Man. I will give the monk this. Definitely got the whole survivability thing going with like the self heals and whatnot. Hey, and we got some torso armor, finally. And an upgrade on our belt. And some pants that look like actual pants instead of shorts with stockings. I mean, don't get me wrong, I like a lady in stockings, but it isn't exactly proper adventuring wear, I don't think. Okay, so we gotta find 31 things and stab the shit out of them. Which we will do. Oh, hey, attack speed bonus. Oh, hey, targets. Nice to meet you. But no, I think it could be a cool concept, if anything, even if it only, you know, goes to two or three quests or whatever. I think it's just a cool concept, you know, basically a community developed module. I think it's a nifty idea. That would be kind of funny. Terrible, but funny. Except, oh wait, oh no, I was gonna say, you know, Diablo 3 doesn't have item durability, but it does, I totally forgot. It's just so completely inconsequential. Alright, back to town.
I need to go back.
Oh, and we have Exploding Palm now. And a passive skill, Exalted Soul. I don't know what that does, we'll find out. Increase maximum spirit by 50. Really? That's kinda nice. Alright, Exploding Palm. Ooh, Wave of Light. Really?
Material. It's been interesting for me to see.
Oh, that's cool.
Places where you and the Nephilim journey. I've heard so much about your adventures.
Doesn't exactly look like a wave of light. Shut up, dude. I hate your fucking voice. I'm not bitter. Don't care about that. Exploding Palm. Enemy to bleed for 1200 weapon damage. It's physical over 9 seconds. If the enemy dies while bleeding, it explodes. So it's a more literal interpretation of the exploding palm technique. Naturally, I'm going to use it because, you know, how badass are we that we are going to literally punch things and they will explode? So let's go ahead and talk to Tyrael and get our goodie bag here.
You have been busy. Please take this.
Thank you, Tyrael.
You have finished all the bounties here, but more await you in other lands.
Yeah, I don't know. I think I mentioned it on the first stream that they should basically just start you out at level 70 so that you can get to, like, the actual game. Because that's where the game starts anyways. I don't know. Seriously, just... there we go. Just gonna stuff that crap in there. Exactly, that's what I was thinking, but then, you know, you'd be kind of... I don't know. Honestly, they should just be like, we don't need levels anymore. Yeah, that might have been it, too. I don't know. Because, like you say, there is no point to leveling in this game. Like, you unlock skills. I understand that... Wait a minute, does that, like, legitimately increase my damage? Really? 43, 64? Yeah, it does, alright. I understand that they're probably doing it as a gating mechanic to keep people from getting overwhelmed by the fact that, oh, holy shit, I've got all of these skills to pick things from. But once you've leveled one character, you're okay, I think. So I don't... It's basically just a time gate... And, like I said on my first stream, you can go from level 1 to level 70 in literally 1 minute if you have people power leveling you. So it's like, yeah, come on. I don't get it. But whatever. Or, you know, if people want to level, let us pick our starting level. actually didn't mean to keep that bell. I don't want to use the bell. I like my lady dragon king. I want this and this and this. Okay. Flamey dragon kick. Now I'm gonna make something explode. Okay, come on, guys. That explosion is not nearly as violent as it should be, I don't think. Well, you can't rescue King because he's dead. Just like Diablo. Oh. As for why every game on tablets is a saga thing, it's a name recognition thing having to do with Candy Crush Saga. It's like, oh, grandma will buy this for their kids, mistaking it, thinking that it's Candy Crush Saga. It's marketing bullshit. The tablet game market, honestly, not something I have any interest in ever catering to simply because it is such a, like, cesspool of just utterly filthy mechanics. Or not mechanics, God words. Utterly filthy practices. It's just disgusting what people do on there, what companies do. Come back here, you little shit. I want your gold! I miss my little dash attack already. I like my exploding palm, but I think I'm gonna probably trade it back. There we go. Wow, he... 5,390... Wow. That's like, I think, probably the largest gold drops I have ever seen in this game. Which is kinda sad. Okay, I wanna take... not this. This. Dashing strike. I like my ability to charge. Okay. The contested villa. Is this the contested villa? No.
I think I... Oh, get away!
Alright, there. Bye. Oh, you cut an arrow with your back. I'm sorry, I didn't save you in time. Ooh, legendary. Pole arm, no less. Probably like the fish spear or whatever. Pledge of Chaldeum. Holy shit, that damage. Wow, went from 44 up to a... Wow, that like tripled my damage. It's a two-hander. But I give zero. Man, we're gonna probably be rolling some face here, I think. Yeah. Honestly, I could believe that. Like, you got your spirit cane floating around. All force ghost bullshit, like. Honestly... I can understand them wanting to kill him, that's fine. I just think that the way that they did it was horrible. I'm not gonna fault them for killing Cain, because I mean, he's like this ancient character, like age-wise, he's gonna die eventually. I just fault them on how they did it, like they had like this no-name villain do it, and it's like, it's just, come on. Have Diablo like tear his soul out or something, not random stupid mini boss whose name I actually can't remember. Magda? I don't remember. But they did a disservice to the character. I mean, he has all this lore, not necessarily lore behind him, but he was a fan favorite, and they just basically threw him under the bus. Wow, those pants are noticeably better than what we have. See, House of Deep Sorrow. Nope. And we are just like literally one-shotting everything. See, there you go. That would be cool. I could see that being like really nifty. You know, he's one of the last Haradrim. His soul is stronger than any other, so only he can bear this burden. And so, you know, he stabs the soul stone into his brain matter. And then have the next game take place, like, say, 200 years later or something. And be like, you know, his will has finally broke and he can no longer hold Diablo at bay or something. I think that would have been really, really cool. Of course, you know, it's too late for anything really cool now. But, oh, we're at level 14. This is where we got, you know, pasted before. We even got a new skill slot. Cyclone Strike. Pull enemies towards you, huh? Eh. Yeah, I know, exactly. I mean, it's not hard. Blizzard has never really been good when it comes to the storylines. Ever. Sadly. But part of that's probably because of who they're marketing to. Again, the lowest common denominator type thing. I don't know. Let's see here. I guess we're gonna just stick with Cyclone Strike here. But no, like, I would play that. That would be, that's like, I think, a legit cool concept right there, and we came up with it in, like you said, you know, it was like 5 minutes, and it's like, bam, we have flushed out a really cool, you know, little thing. I don't know, who knows. Truthfully, they could retcon the entirety of Diablo 3's storyline, and I would have absolutely no complaints. I would not bitch at all. Be like, yep, okay. I played the game. I had fun with it for what it was. I miss none of the crappy storyline, though. And we have, of course, gone in the absolute wrong way. But no, I think that would have been really, really cool. Like you said, have Cain taken on. That would have been an excellent way. Because I'm sure that there are going to be additional expansions. Excuse me, for Diablo 3. And that could be a cool way to, you know, cap off, say, the second or third or however many expansions they're going to do before the new game. Call it, like, I don't know. I don't know. They didn't even necessarily have to make it part of, like, the base game. It could be something they add later on. Have a content patch, say it, like, the Haradrim's Last Sacrifice or something like that, and go for it. But, I don't know. Wow, that was over quick. It's being hopeful about it, I have learned that Blizzard isn't going to do the fun thing, they're going to do the money
thing. This is all Justinian's fault. Some king he is.
You're not wrong. But part of it comes from, I mentioned this last stream, that the original Diablo was basically initially designed just to be a roguelike, and roguelikes, you know, their storylines are generally, there's some MacGuffin at the bottom of this dungeon, and if you get it, you turn into a god or something. And so, yeah, you know, I'll give it to them. In the first game, you know, fight to the bottom of this dungeon and kill the devil. That's okay, that is enough reason for me to go to a dungeon and stab things to death. But then they're like, well, we've got to give this game an actual storyline. And Diablo 2's storyline was not bad. It was generic, but it wasn't bad.
Thanks for helping.
With this, it is legitimately bad.
Why did you have to die, brother? I was never meant to be king. The nobles threaten revolt.
Oh, I was like, who's talking? And there's a king's journal going on. But yeah, I don't know. Diablo 2 was, you know, there was just enough story there to kind of keep you plugging away. And then Diablo happened, and they're like, we've got to exposit everything now. And they, of course, added Lia, who is completely unlikable, and I don't know. I think they're trying too hard, and they're fighting with a stacked deck against them. It's like, just be like, Diablo's back. He's I don't know. He's back and he's eviler, and he's got an afro and is selling crack cocaine to the little children of Karas. Oh, by the way, you're on the other side of the world and you have to fight to the other side of the world to kill him and stop this. I'm like, okay, I'll fight to the other side of the world to stop Diablo from creating crack babies. I'm like, I don't care. I legitimately do not care about the storyline of these games. Nobody does. You're not playing Diablo for the storyline, so it's like, why bother investing so much into it? Unless Skill Wave of the 100 Fists. This sounds like something we'd use. Is that one of the primaries? Yes, of course. Okay, I actually know what this is. But he's got a new hat, exactly. Like, that can just be the difference between one game to another, is Diablo just has, like, larger and more elaborate hats. I'd play it. Whatever. I want his hat. You know, go the Team Fortress method. Depending on how many hats you have, you may be more or less badass than your friends. So this is basically just kind of a... I don't know how I... I'm not particularly attached to my Kung Fu Punch of Doom, and this does send things flying quite satisfyingly. We're going Bruce Lee on these scarabs. No, we'll try this out for a little while. Why not? But, yeah, like I said, it's a Diablo game. I'm not here for the story. I'm here to click mouse buttons, occasionally press keys, and watch violence happen on my screen. I don't need to know why I'm killing Malphie. I'll just be like, he's a bad dude. He's an angel of death, and he's stealing people's souls, and I'll be like, okay, that's enough reason for me. I don't expect, you know, books and shit on this. I don't care. I know some people do. I'm just not one of them. And I have never been one of them. Blizzard games aren't good enough. Well, I shouldn't say they're not good enough. They're not interesting enough to make me want to go out and buy literature based on them. And I've read some of it. I've read, like, the World of Warcraft books, and they're terrible. You see, but is he a bad enough dude to rescue the president? That's the real question. You know, Carmageddon is such a good game. They actually just released a new one recently too. I don't know, a reimagining or something. And from what I understand, it's buggier than, you know. We'll just say it's buggier than the South in July, instead of going a little off kilter with that. There may be children watching, and I don't want to scar their poor little fragile minds. So what is this thing we're looking to kill here? Over this way. Nothing. Get out of my way. You guys, seriously? Yeah, that's what happens. I've got a legendary spear here, and I, like, insta-give all of you. They are nothing to me now! You know, it's getting serious when I start putting on the Arnold expression. Oh, hey, level 16.
A vicious strike.
Active skill unlocked, Serenity. That movie. Passive skill, Transcendence. Oh man, I killed the Unique and I didn't even notice he was there. Such a his spirit just rolled over his grave. Okay. I'm gonna loot this. Seriously, guys, I just want to look at my inventory and my skills and see what these new things are that I have. Where is this Serenity? Serenity! Damage absorption shield, don't care. Get out of here. I have things. But if I have also Sears and- Oh really, now my heal damages things. I'm okay with that? Sure, why not? That's not- that move speed increase after you use it. I don't really particularly care. But, whatever. Lashing. Let's see, how does this look? I like my flaming kick. I like fire. So while we don't get our first thing for Way of the Hundred Fists until level 24, that's kind of painful. Whatever. Okay, so map. And we are going to go to Death's Embrace. Whatever that is. And I'm going to get a drink. Hey there, water. It's good to see you. Okay. Probably go for, I don't know, another half hour here. I gotta get to bed. First chest. Oh, I really should not have just done that, but I did. Okay. here because I am also in Canaan. Man, this legendary spear has really kind of turned this into slightly more easy than normal easy mode here. So what do we get? Oh, a quiver. Man, I am... You can't see it, but I am literally quivering with joy. It's a terrifying sight. Damn it. I haven't even been paying attention to all of the items that we've been picking up. I've just been kind of grabbing crap. I'd assumed that there really wasn't anything too interesting. And there's not! What a twist. Hey, guys! And a resplendent chest. Wait, was there a resplendent chest down there, too? Did I miss it? Oh, I did. Shit. I didn't even notice that. I thought I had hit it, but apparently not. Wow. Thanks for letting me know about that, Captain Planet. You just netted me some life regen. I was, like, drooling on myself, apparently. Summoner of the Dead. I like that my heal now does damage. Reminds me of Warhammer Online. Probably the only PvP-centric MMO that I have ever played and really liked. Even the healers in that game kick, like, copious amounts of ass.
My strength has increased.
So this is why I'm streaming, because if I were playing alone, I wouldn't have noticed that, and I wouldn't have even known to be sad. Second-sided strike. Man, I'm learning all these skills. I'm actually kind of liking the monk, truth be told. No? Where is seven-sided strike? Seven-sided strike. Dash rapidly between nearby. Holy shit. Okay, sure. Freaking 5,600 damage. 5,600% damage, I should say. If this is what I think it is, I think I'm gonna like this ability. My fiance plays a monk. Well, she played a monk. I don't know if she's playing her anymore. And she has this one ability where it, like, kind of just teleports you around and you butcher everything. And I'm gonna go ahead and assume that that's what this is, and if it is, I'm gonna be pretty pleased with it here in a moment. There's like two of you, that's not enough. I need a big group. Come on, game, give me like 70 things. Still not enough. Okay. Yeah, that's what it was. Okay, that was pretty badass. Oh, we got achievement. Ambuscade from the Seven Strikes. Hit seven enemies with one seven-side strike. Okay, thanks, game. Because I care. Okay, let's go up here.
That ability is not yet recharged.
That 30-second cooldown makes me kind of sad, though. There's probably a rune to shorten that up. Nope. Yeah. Level 43, here we come. I think that... Was that? Yes, it is. Wow. My god. That thing didn't have anything I care about on it, but... Wow. I think a belt? Crappy belt. As I'm stuck, look at that, infinite stuck on terrain because pathfinding. Man, I got nothing. This character definitely has a lot of AoE potential, which I really like. In pretty much every action RPG I play, AoE is kind of the king. Okay, looks like we got one more, and it is right down here, conveniently enough. Hey guys. That is like the coolest thing. Seriously? There we go. Oh, and we get a radiant chest for it, too. Only a couple blues though, which are not worth anything. Seriously, dude. Seriously, get out of here. Okay, up next. Oh, don't tell me. Okay, I'm like, don't tell me we have to kill Malthael. However the hell you pronounce his name. I think it's Malthael. Because that is not a fight we would win. I don't know. That is just a tough fight. At least for me. I don't know. To kill Almash the Grizzly. I guess he's a real bear to deal with. Oh, kill me. Freaking Hogan. Buggets. That's right, everybody. Gather around, I'm gonna tell you a story. Bam.
Your strength fails.
There's my story. I'm like Emerald, except instead of bringing seasoning, I bring death. Hey, I was getting ready to do that. Game depriving me of my roundhouse kicks to victory. Oh, I see you over there at Tusked Bogan. I don't even remember why, but I remember hating coming through this area in my initial playthrough of Reaper of Souls. Like I said, I don't even know why. But I remember it being most cantankerous. Violence. A Nephilim Guidestone. I don't think that's really gonna do anything for us, is it? Oh, hey!
Please stop this mindless violence!
Man, Hot Fuzz is a movie I've gotta go back and watch again. Funny stuff. Come here, you. Oh, hey. I don't even know what that was, but I just exploded it. Hey there. Seriously, guys. Well, if you're electrified, I only need to hit you a couple times then to make sure that I don't get electrified a lot. So we have a castle here. This is interesting. I've never seen this before. Looks like they're unearthing it. Yeah, I know that the boss is down there, but oh, now I walk right past it. Not a smart man.
Feel the wrath of Yitar.
Yitar, alright. Fight Lord Curtis's ghostly attendants. I'm going to find them wanting. Well, that was like throwing swords at me. Restless Lord of the Marsh. Well, he's gonna be the dead Lord of the Marsh here momentarily.
Now it will never be finished!
Sorry, Lord Curtis.
Curse you, Saul! You sold me this piece of waterlogged land to build my castle on!
Oh my god.
I will have the last laugh, you
dog! Is it gonna
dog.
Sink?
I will build my castle here, and it will be the grandest castle ever! Do you hear me, Saul? Ever!
Is that a fucking Monty Python and the Holy Grail reference? It's gotta be. That's another thing that I honestly don't like that Blizzard has taken to doing, and they've been doing it in World of Warcraft since, like, Wrath of the Lich King or Cataclysm. I can't remember where they started doing it really heavily, where they're making just all of these pop culture references and, like, meme references and stuff. And I just think it is the most, like, obnoxious thing. I know I'm in the minority, but damn. Alright, where are we going? Out of time. Oh god, don't tell me I have to kill Malthael. Seriously, guys.
You are defeated.
You are really defeated. And internet's held together well. I have dropped a whopping 52 frames this entire stream. 0.2%. Okay. Just killing demons. I can do that. This is one of the cooler areas, but I don't know. I like the old Pandemonium Fortress better. This seems kinda needlessly grandiose. I hate these stupid things. Hey, move speed increase. I can appreciate you. Appreciate you enough to take you out for a nice fish dinner and never call you back. Okay. Go ahead and destroy that. You demon, demon, demon. Come on, guys. Everybody gather around. Gather round and die. I don't know, I kind of like our little machine gun punch. It's not, like, insane, but it seems to be pretty reliable AoE. I hate stupid executioner things, just because of the knockback. The knockback, I just don't like enemies in these games with knockback, just because it slows you down. I shouldn't say it slows you down, but it slows, I don't know, play down. I will make that trade. No. And that's crap. Okay. Well, we got one of them here. Man, our damage is just out of control with this spear. I'd almost be tempted to bump the difficulty up even further. Alright, guys, let's do this. That was over quick.
My strength has increased.
Wow. Alright. Back to... Seriously, guys. Back to Tyriel. And we got our fourth skill, Mantra of Salvation. Oh god, these things have passives and stuff like what the Crusaders do. Things I'm totally not gonna use. You and nearby allies gain an additional 20% increased resistance to all elements for 3 seconds. Pass. Let's go ahead and see what else I have that might be desirable there. Serenity is kind of tempting, but I don't really necessarily get into enough, like, oh shit moments. I think what I'm going to do is take Mystic Ally at 22. For now, it can just kind of sit here. But... ooh, Transcendence is nice, too. I'll take that, some extra healing. Because, hey, survivability. Nothing there, nothing there, nothing there, and nothing here until level 24, that's right. Alright, Tyriel, give me my loot.
The world is safer now.
Yeah, I know.
There are more bounties.
Alright. The last one of these we got was pretty supremely disappointing. This one less so. Alright, got a bunch of gems. Oh, really? Auto-picking up gems and stuff, that's handy as hell. Wow, and we got a staff that's actually... I don't know if I want to give up that life on kill. There's a lot of life on kill. I think I'm going to stick with the spear. Even though this is better damage-wise, I want to be able to heal myself really quickly. Okay. So I'm just going to go ahead and vendor all of this stuff. I'm not particularly worried about it. Go ahead and sell that. And I'm sure... wow, I was going to say, I'm sure what this guy has is just all crap, but... surprise, surprise. Go ahead and repair, and just throw all of this into the stash because we can't do anything with it, and we're gonna leave because otherwise we will have no more tasks at hand, I don't think, and we're gonna bump the difficulty up a little bit here, I think. Go from hard. Seriously? You actually have to... I can only play on up to expert. That chaps my ass. I was gonna crank it up to master. Alright. Whatever. That's kind of obnoxious. Because, like, I'm not gonna play through the damn single player campaign in hardcore mode again. I did it once. They gave us adventure mode. That's what I really wanna play. Screw you, Diablo. Okay. First things first, though, Kandala, what do you have with regards to chest armor?
Maybe you can find a use for that.
Anything
Sunday.
Yes. 32 life per second healed. Nice. Alright, that's worth it. I might as well spend them when I've got them. To bring you these fine goods. Okay, buy that. Upgrade my boots. Man, you know that you're like still a scrub when you're getting upgrades from the shop.
I have some my goods are without equal. I've collected them from all parts of this world.
Yes, and all of the parts of the people of this world. I mean. Okay, so is that the only upgrade he's got? Yes, but it is an upgrade nonetheless. Bam. So that's another problem, is like you level so quickly that your gear is basically obsolete by the time you found, you know, half of your suit. It's ridiculous. Like, I'm still, like, I'm sure, yeah, level 8, really need to see. Level 8, level 7, and I'm level 19.
Sure, I may do business with some unsavory types, but I pass the savings on to you.
Okay, he didn't have anything there, you know. Intelligence pass. That, on the other hand, I think I'm actually going to buy two of. I'm actually... Let's see, this could be... Wow. Heal like 120 points. Now that'll be like... That's on hit, right? Oh, wow. That's... Wow. We are going to be having a shed load of healing here. Let's see. Strength, vitality... So we don't have any dex gems, sadly. Well, I am, I guess, losing some vitality. But, eh, no, I want to save that for helms. We're just going to put these on and... Life per hit, 96. And, like, each hit from this is going to count. Oh my god. Alright, where are we headed here? Oh, looks like Act 1 and 5 again. Okay. The Queen's Dessert, huh? What, are we supposed to kill Arane or whatever her name is? Oh, I see that the stream conked out for just a second there. Well, not really conked out, but doped up a little bit. No, we're not killing What's-Her-Face again. Dang it. Oh my god. Like, we're probably assuming that, like, each of the little hits that we do here counts for healing. Yeah, I don't know. Like, it wasn't... The stream didn't die. It just, like, basically dropped some frames. So, like, if you had noticed anything, it would have probably been, like... Like, it might have skipped for a second. Or it might have, you know, just kind of, like, gotten a little sluggish or something. Not really anything crazy. But our healing now is going to be just insane. Wow. Smash the cocoon. Hey there, buddy. Get out of here while you still can. Don't turn into a spider on me. Or I'm gonna make you dead, just like everything else. That violence. Oh, hey, guys. Oh, hey, Danny. Fucking Tommy was so... I'm sorry that your internet is so cantankerous. Believe me, I know what it's like, because your internet now is basically how my internet was when I was out in Indiana. Like, a cloud would pass overhead and we'd lose internet. It was just fucking abysmal. So, like, you having really crappy internet, is that just happening to be... where you live currently, or is that like just a countrywide our internet is balls phenomenon? I just mowed through this crowd of spiders. Aw, that's rough. I am sorry. Like, that's honestly kind of surprising to me, because like the reason our internet's so like terrible out here is because our infrastructure is so old. Whereas I figured you guys would be somewhat newer, although your government being what it is, they do kind of like to just screw you guys because they can, so there's that, I guess. Gotcha. Oh my god, that thing had a cow in it. Get out of here, Bessie. I'll protect you. You leave my cowgirl alone. Bessie, where are you going? I don't want to leave you alone in here with these monsters, but I'm gonna have to. Where is this? Down here. We shall meander. But yeah, no, it's like I can't believe that you guys' internet. Like, I mean, I believe it, but it's kind of mind-boggling that your internet is so terrible. Considering you're not like Zimbabwe or rural Indiana, for that matter. Rough. I do hope that the new network does actually fix things for you, because like it's one thing to have slow internet, and it's a completely different thing to have like internet that is both slow and completely unreliable. Like you can learn to deal with slow internet, but unreliable internet is just like horror. Like, I wasn't looking for sympathy. Like, on my case, it's the whole unreliable thing. I hate unreliable stuff. And I have never had an ISP that wasn't unreliable. So, like, when it's working really well, I'm happy. But as soon as it conks out, considering what we're paying for it, like, immediate rage. But yeah, no, it is nice being able to upload, like, a rendered episode of Xena in, like, literally 10 minutes. It's pretty swanky, you know. Just saying. Let's see what we have here. Mana, mantra activation. I don't care about mantra thing. I'm going to take this thing that gives me extra spirit. Because hell yeah. And nothing new here. Yeah, I don't know, like, what the deal is. It's a recent thing. So, I don't know. They've been, since I bitched at them really hard and, you know, figured out where the hole in their system was, it's been okay. I mean, it's been kind of conking off a little here and there, but generally speaking, it's been pretty solid. I would probably honestly bitch about it less if I had, like, backlogs of video, but since I do things how I do things, where I, like, record and upload same day, having the internet decide it's going to be, you know, absolutely terrible, like, throws a wrench in things, because I don't like missing uploads. Like, that I haven't uploaded Titan Quest yet, for example, is constantly niggling at the back of my mind. And, you know, when it's literally impossible to me, you know, it irks me. Because, you know, I have a schedule, and I don't like deviating from my schedule. Especially when it's, you know, no fault of my own. I'm gonna murder all you guys.
They'll be upon us at any moment. Stand firm, brothers, and they will sing of our valor through the ages.
I can't tell if that is Kil'thas, or... Shit, what's his name? I don't remember. Black dude, used Phil Lamar. There we go. Oh, that was a waste. Come on, throw something challenging at me here. I'm like so hilariously overpowered now. I got so much life regen. Oh, here we go. I'm taking some damage. I was.
The dead cannot forget. The souls cannot move on.
And that is crap. And this is junk. This is unusable. And those are my old rings. Alright. Okay. Field of Misery. Let's go kill the data miner. Okay. But no, like, I'd like to be able to stream more regularly. Like, not necessarily have, like, super long streams, but, you know, I wouldn't mind being able to stream a couple times a week. for late night streams, but with my internet such as it is, I don't like being like, you know, I don't like announcing a stream and then, okay. I don't like announcing a stream and then having to cancel it because my internet has decided it's going to be particularly terrible. And, you know, it's frustrating. It's just very, very frustrating. And there's really not a lot I can do about it. Except look, like I hate to say this, but it makes me look forward to eventually moving and hopefully getting onto Comcast. Because, like, they might rape you, but at least their service is reliable from what I understand. Never thought I'd say that. Okay, so this should just... Oh, and he ran, you shit-eating... Fudge. Man, waste my 30-second cooldown ability on you. Freaking run. Well, that ain't gonna save you. Engulfing Comet. Can't even use it. Okay.
A worthy challenge.
Okay, we got some rares. Well, not rares. Yeah, they'd be rare because they're not uniques. Pop my Uber ability here. And then AoE them down because that is what we do. Okay, and some Greaves, which are better damage, but I'm not gonna trade my toughness and stuff for them. Hey guys, I'm really just like killing you to fill out the numbers at this point. Come on, give me another good size. Well, actually, I was gonna say that group there is gonna be enough. Okay, up next is Scavenger Den or Bludgeon Skull. We're gonna go to Bludgeon Skull because I hate finding the Scavenger Den. Because I can never find the Scavenger Den. So we'll probably clear this bounty and then I will call it. And then, I don't know. I want to say maybe stream tomorrow. I don't know. It depends. It depends. I do kind of have an itch to play some Neverwinter Nights. But I don't know. We'll see. Oh, poor Teresa is... just... Oh, man. She didn't get the notification about this until 3 hours late, and I've been streaming for, like, 3 hours and 10 minutes. Ah, she's gonna... If she pop... Just spare her Captain Plan. Just tell her to catch it on YouTube, because otherwise she's gonna pop in and see, like, 5 or 10 minutes of gameplay, and then... It'll be the end of the stream. Yes, gather around and AoE. And yes, that was a calculated risk right there because I knew I was right on top of gaining the level. So I was not expecting to die there. Yeah, roughly. More life on kill. But it's got fucking intelligence. I'm gonna hold on to it. That's a maybe. Maybe I can do stuff with my enchanter. But with these videos, since I'm doing them at a higher bitrate now, the video files are larger, so this is probably gonna be... if I had to ballpark it... Maybe... 2.5-3 hour upload? I think, if I don't have my bandwidth cap for uploading, which I normally do, because I can upload at like 1400 kbps a second, but normally I only upload at 800 so that I can actually do things on the internet, like games or whatever. Doing it at 800 would probably be like a 3 or 4 hour upload, maybe a little more. It depends on the file size, because like an episode of Dark Souls is like 4 gigs, 5 gigs, and that's about it. 2 hour upload. So, well, 2.5-3. So I would peg probably, because this has actually been a pretty long stream, I'm not going to do it in one piece, but if I would, I would peg this at probably a pretty decent length upload as far as, you know, uploads on my internet go. Probably like 4 or 5 hours, maybe. I mean, it's Believe me, I remember the days of literal 20-hour uploads back in Indiana. I know what you're going through here, Captain.
This is not ready yet.
These guys are not going to do to me what they want to do to me. Freaking jailers. I'm gonna keep one of my charges ready at all times so that I can get away from them if I have to. They got moment's notice. Even if I have to go the other way. Alright, I'm gonna pop my resistance in the intro because why not? There we go. That was a pretty challenging pack there. Carved siphon. Looks like an axe. Ooh. Minus 20% toughness. That's some vitality and 200 life per hit. Hello, and I'm gonna hold on to this. I know in one of the recent patches they really buffed the life to hit, which is, I assume, why I'm seeing such large numbers. So that's a substantial amount. We're up to almost 300 life per hit, which is, you know, a fifth of our health, a sixth of our health, every hit. Like, this is taking me back to Diablo 2 days of running, like, a Zealotin with just incredible life leech, where you basically just stand in a horde and they can't kill you unless they can one-shot you. Nice. Our damage is still pretty solid, too. That spear really did help. And don't think I don't see you raging on Twitter. I got multiple monitors, man. I'm watching everything. Like, you see, like, fucking The Watchmen with Ozymandias at the end of it with, the, like, 50 monitors in front of him. That's me, except it's, you know, video game.
The fetid, pallid malaise has fallen over the manor.
It's a malaise, and it may or may not be fetid and or pallid. And hey, they gave me my little marker here to know where I'm going. Nah, she'll be able to catch it on probably Monday, assuming I remember to upload it. We know all your secrets. I know that is a Simpsons reference. The fucking little radio show they were doing. I remember that. That's classic Simpsons. There's a door there. I'm like, why can't I walk in this general direction? Man, I'm really liking how the monk plays. I'm not gonna lie about that. It's very satisfying. But in a different way to the barbarian. The barbarian was just kind of like hulking destroyer satisfying. This is more like finesse fucking shit up, I guess, if that makes sense. And I really like that my heal, like, does damage. Really like that. Whoa! That was a hell of a hit. Note to self, their windups hurt. Goddamn. Okay, where is this thing? I don't know. Like, one thing that I do think this game is missing is, like, a legit minion master class, but with how everything is done in this, you really couldn't have one. Because, like, I would love to have my old, like, necromancer back, for example. But it just doesn't fit with Diablo 3, which kind of makes me sad. Yeah, let's just kill this guy.
My strength has increased.
Just like immediately kill him. Accidentally pick up a crappy staff. Absolutely nothing else. And we have a chest with junk in it. Hey guys.
What you ask
is, and there's Mystic Ally. Okay. Where is he? There he is. Okay. So now we have a Mystic Monk thing. It's kind of like the Shadow Assailant or whatever it was from Diablo 2's Assassins. Find enemies. too overwhelming. Run. Okay, so we gotta find the scavenger then. So can this thing die? When the ally dies, it is reborn after 5 seconds. Okay. Only does 190 damage, so that's kinda crap. Or 130 damage. And if I actually use the ability, it does a little bit extra. Okay. And I got feared there. Just pop this. Get this thing a little bit less than I would have liked there, but what am I gonna do? Not to bitch about it. I wouldn't mind having a health bar for the minion. That'd be kinda handy. I just still can't believe how much we're healing with our attack. Might as well have it buff itself, why not? I hate nightmares. I know I've bitched about it. I know I've bitched about it during my Let's Play. I hate enemy attacks that take away control of the player in any game.
I must wait.
Like, it does not matter what it is. It is just the most obnoxious thing. There. Okay, what do we got here? Some boots? Yeah, sure. Wrong map. Like, this is not the map I want.
Not be done.
Okay, I'm really just like trying to find this place. Just like one shots everything. Beautiful. Can't wait to see what it does with some of like the runes on it and stuff. Hey guys, how are you doing? I don't particularly care about you. And since we've got so much health on hit, like, this heals us for, you know, 750 to 900 plus 300. It's glorious. Bone pile. Seriously, guys. Come on now. I mean, they're doing damage to me. I'm not gonna say they're not. It's just that my... great. And they're nightmarish, you know, because that's more of what I wanted. It's just that my self-healing is so great right now that stuff just cannot... like, my health bar drops and then it just is immediately full again. And that, like, right there, just takes me right back to my Zealotin days of Diablo 2. Good times. Come on. You lose. We got something there. Let's see what that is. What do we got? Boots that... I'll take that trade. We actually need some more hit points. We're kind of hurting. I'd like to have, like, closer to 2,500 as opposed to 1,900. Some gold and 1,400 experience points and a protection shrine. Nice.
I will not do that.
No. Got to it first, sorry minion. But you're just not quick enough. Not yet. This thing. Okay. Seriously though, where is this place? And I don't like that you can't move while this, while your like big mini map is up. Kind of a oxymoron there, but
you are defeated.
No, I don't know. If I stream tomorrow, I might do some Neverwhere Nights. I'll do some poking around. I think I still have it installed. Oh, I did not mean to do that. I'm wasting my everything here. I do have infinite dungeons, which, as I mentioned earlier, is basically like a roguelike version of Neverwinter Nights that BioWare released when they were doing their premium modules. I don't think you can get it anymore. I legit don't believe it's sold because of their rights. Like, they don't have rights to sell it anymore, so I'm like 99% certain there is no legal way to obtain it anymore. So I might play that a little bit. It's not bad. It's not exactly the most advanced thing, and it's very, very easy to get hilariously overpowered. But it might be fun to kind of troll around in, make some hilariously ridiculous character, and just, you know, the face roll of the world. Yeah, here. Arcane Enchanted. This, honestly, of all of the unique rare abilities, this is probably my favorite because it is the most unique of them. Like, it's not unfair because, you know, you can just move out of the way of it, but it's just a really cool mechanic. And we have another legendary there, some armor. And you do not want to stand in it just like that, because that, I'm lucky that I didn't die. Okay, Chivalry Terror. Let's see what this... Let's see what this armor is. Actually, don't recognize this one. I know they added new stuff with, like, the seasons. The Aquila Cuirass. Dex, it's not banned. Ceremonial armor commemorating the chieftain Gaeold's victory over the wildmen from the east. Well, it's an upgrade straight across the board, so of course I'm going to equip it. Alright. Does it look like anything? Not really, no. Not a whole lot of uniqueness. Like, that's not the word I want to use, but there's not a lot of variety. There we go. There's really not a lot of variety in armor. Like, there is, but a lot of it's like palette swaps and stuff. I mean, I can't really complain because, like, Diablo 2 had, what, like, four different armor sets per character. You had, like, your naked, light, medium, heavy, and then, like, ancient plate, and that was about it. So, it's better than nothing, and it's mostly just a minor complaint, kind of, for complaint's sake. Basically what I'm saying is I need to shut the fuck up. I don't know, this character is feeling pretty good, though. Like, you know, we're feeling pretty powerful. I know now that I need to watch out for things like Frozen. That was a learning experience. I want to watch out for Jailers. I also need to watch out for Wallers. So, like, there are a list of enemies that I need to be careful of. Basically, anything that takes away player control, I need to be careful of. Buff my minion there. Get out of that. Buster Cluck over there. AoE. Alright, we should have this. There we go. Not too bad. And crap. Yes. Those are not particularly great, it's just dexterity on them. But I will take the extra damage over what I had on my other ones. I really should go faff with the Mystic a little bit, go and level her up a little and see if I can do anything with her. I mean, if it carries over from one character to another, like on hardcore, if I do it now, it's just kind of saving me the trouble of doing it later. Because of Desecrators. Got them nice and clumped together here. Wow, that was violent and sudden and over very quickly. Okay, got a couple of yellows. Ring, ooh, 90 life per hit. Well, that's just a flat upgrade in addition to the vitality. Those I'm not too interested in. Well, no, that I can't even use. And the pants. No, they're intelligence. Wait, no, those were the ones I was gonna re-roll. Don't be stupid, Gene. Okay. So this should be, like, about it here, I would think. Yeah, three enemies remaining, two enemies remaining. I had to overkill it, naturally. Is there anything down here? No. Okay. Expected to new Tristram. We will see what kind of goodies we get here. I will probably sell things, fuss with the Mystic a little bit, and then we'll be done. Been going for almost 3.5 hours. Yeah,
Templar. I've dug up some new things for you to take a look at.
Buy all of my crap. I should probably not be selling it. I should probably be breaking it down. I just don't care enough to. Because
the
reasons.
Well, you have finished.
Give him my goodie bag. Okay. So take that. Take that, gems. I like that it auto picks up all the gems if you click on one of them. That is satisfying. Okay, that's useless. There's more crafting materials. an improved gem there, which, like, strength is useless to us. And I might as well, I guess. Why not? Okay, Mystic. All of my money is belong to you. There we go. Up to rank, like, I think it's 9 of 10? Okay, so what can I do with this? Seriously? And I'm sure she can't do anything.
You
can only enchant legendaries. Can you do anything with this? Alright, so I can fuss with weapons, just not armor. Well, what can this turn into? And of course I don't have the crafting materials for it. I'm gonna fuss with that. Let's see, I should be able to hopefully get some of those by salvaging the stuff that I've got on me here. Oh, of course you give me the freaking tears. Dang it. Okay, let's see if we can do anything with anything else. I don't want to transmogrify. I'm sure this is going to be the same. Oh, that needs to be level 11. Head? No, 12 boots. There we go. Nope, again, this is stuff we don't have. And, all right, here we go. What can I get for this? Crap. About this one. I'll see if we can reroll some life on hit. I'll go ahead and go with the 5% extra gold. We're gonna just reroll this. 10% extra gold. 10% extra gold. Oh, and we are out of money. Barely. Dang it. Let's see here. What can we transmogrify this into? Anything cool? We're running around with a big damn hammer. That's tempting, except it's 25,000 gold pieces. Damn. We'll just keep the axe. And I'm not too worried about fashion yet, because look at us. We're wearing, like, piss yellow shirt and just random other stuff here. I do think I'm gonna call it now. It is later than I had intended to go, but this is a good streaming session. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for tuning in. Those that you did, those of you catching this on YouTube, thank you for watching. And those of you wanting to follow these in the future, hit up the description box, wherever it may be. You will find a link to my Hitbox channel. Subscribe, and you will receive email notifications about these streams when they go live. And that's all I got. So, as per usual, folks, take it easy, and I hope you have a good one. Later.